Google, just double click on it. So this is one of a very good search engine. So just you can type there as NCBI, okay, and just put enter. So you did you remember the previous one what I have shown you? So the site gets opened up. Just go and click on to that site, the home page will appear. So this is the home page of it, okay. Now once you get into this home page, go back to this all database. Are you able to see here? So go to this all database. You see project, samples, books, then genome. Then you have NCBI website. Now I want only protein. So click the word protein. Okay. Now let I show you the same thing only so that it becomes easy for you to understand. Type the word insulin and then go and click the word search. So the moment you click the word search, you will be able to see the page getting opened up. Are you able to see the same page you see? You got it. Now as I move down, are you able to see insulin precursor, insulin, octodone, digest? This also you can take it, insulin, camelus, 110 amino acid protein, insulin, homo sapiens, insulin, absalvia, insulin, bos taurus, insulin, scrofota, insulin isoform 2 precursor, homo sapiens only children's, but don't take it because it is a study. Some scientists have taken this insulin and they've studied and they've deposited that amino acid protein over here, which we don't want. We want only the insulin direct protein data, which is available here. Now insulin partial, insulin partial, then insulin another one species, insulin another one species, insulin another one, insulin pre-pro protein, danio, don't take pre-pro protein, take only insulin. Here also you have insulin gallus, gallus, then insulin partial like that. So alligator insulin, again partial, don't go for this. So I told you that in the first page you are able to see 1 to 20. You can go to next over here, it will give you from 21 to 40. See you got 21, it goes on till 40. Again you go to the next, you will get the next page giving you 41 to the 60 proteins related only to insulin, children. It's only related to insulin. It will be going on giving you all the results. So you can see how many number of pages are here. Are you able to see the page numbers? We are only in page number 3. There are so many other pages information also related to the insulin protein, but I want only the insulin. Jalakshmi. So I want only insulin protein cup. So what I'll do now, you see, listen carefully. You have to go and click it. Don't click on anywhere else. It will take you to somewhere else. So click only here, insulin protein. So I am clicking here, insulin protein of Homo sapiens. When I click it, it will take few seconds for the page to get opened up. See, the page has got opened up. So it will give lot and lot of information which has been deposited by the authors. So you have to go down, scroll down. Don't tell I'm not getting. You will get it as you scroll down. Down and down you have to go. Last you will be able to find the amino acid sequence. So you should know the single letter words of all the 20 amino acids, then only you will know where it is. So they have given here. So what I will do, you are supposed to just copy it, control and C, copy it, go to your search and open one Word document. So you have to open the Word document and there you are going to put 2-3 enters and then paste it. Now when I'm pasting it, are you able to see here one number is there? That number should not be there. When you're giving the information to the searching process and the alignment, all these things should not be there. And you remember what we have taken this protein as, insulin, and open a bracket and write it as Homo sapiens and close the bracket. So we have finished retrieving the amino acid sequence of this protein, that is the insulin, from the Homo sapiens. We have done with this one. On top, what you are supposed to do? name of the student, then your roll number must be there, then you have to write the date. So all this data is mandatory when you are going to submit the assignment to me. If nothing is there, I will not consider. So now go back again to your page. Now this is the page where we have taken the insulin protein, is it not? Now we will go back again. Just go back, you will be able to get. So now let me show you for another one, insulin boss torus. I am going to just click on top of it. So now again the page will get opened up. So same procedure only. Just go down, you are able to see the amino acid sequence. Just you have to copy it, go to your Word document and then put enter. You should know how to do it. Then paste it. Now here, this is also which protein now? This is also insulin only, but I have taken it from the another organism, boss torus. Please mention that one also. And one of the good way of presenting the data is putting it in the format which is called, generally I prefer to go with Times New Roman. You can use that standard protocol and label it. So now you see, now what is the problem here? The first one nicely it is starting with MALW, but what is the problem in the second row? We are having the number 61. So I have removed it and retained only the amino acid sequence over here. Okay, so I am done now with the first step of taking the data from the NCBI site for the insulin amino acid sequence I have taken. Now you go back. Now again I have gone back. If you just put back and back, you will be getting the NCBI site again. So in this NCBI site, your right side, you are able to see the word BLAST, is it not? Just you click on that word BLAST. The moment you click, the page will get opened up. Same page only I showed you. Now I want to do only protein BLAST. So do only the protein BLAST. Click on that one, the page will get opened up. So you can see you get only one box initially where it is only entering the space for the query sequence, but I want even another box to deposit the subject sequence. So I'll go with this one. So now I'm going to just click. If I click, you see the tick mark over there, and you have to just wait for few seconds. Once if it is ticked, you are able to see two boxes are now there in front of you, is it not? One is indicating the query sequence, other one is indicating the subject sequence. So now what you will do, go to your Word document. Insulin Homo sapiens is there. That sequence you just have to control C. Copy it, come back to the site. On the first box, you just paste it. Control P, you can do it, okay? Come to the next box. Go to the Word document and you can copy the sequence and you just copy it and you can paste it over here. So I copied and pasted it. As I told you, when you're giving the inputs into this boxes, make sure that there are no any extra words or extra letters or any like inverted commas or dots or full stops, slashes, numbers, not there. Only the amino acid sequence must be there. If you give with all those dots or any apostrophe marks and all, it will not give you the result. So that is why you have to be very clear when you are giving the inputs into a program. So I've given the query sequence, I've given the subject sequence, and I'm just going to click on the word BLAST. You will not get the result immediately. It will show you, the page will be displayed to you within few seconds, and you can see that the result has been displayed to me. Now you can see that I've given the pure protein sequence, then the query sequence length, this is the subject sequence length, it has taken into consideration. Now that's all is the page. Where do you find the results now? The results will be here only. Graphic summary, alignments and dot plot. So first result is what? Graphic summary. Just click on the word graphic summary and I'm getting the result. So in the first one, what I showed you in the PPT, I compared insulin of Homo sapiens with another or a species and I found a pink color. similar even in the case of Bose torus sequence comparison with that of a human sequence. When I compare it, you see again I'm getting a pink color, which is the blast hit, top one blast hit for the subject sequence, which is showing you that the similarity can be between only 80 to 200. So what you will do now, children, you have to take a screenshot. Don't take a screenshot by using your mobile. I will tell you how to do that one also now. So once you come to your Word document page and type the word as results. Under that, put first one and type the word as graphic summary, and under that you paste your result. You see, you got the result now. So this is your first result, that is graphic summary. Now go back again to your NCBI site, and that is your BLAST site where the results are there, and now click on the word alignment. The moment you click, you see now you are able to see the sequence alignment. You see earlier same thing, M and T, L and R, R is arginine, L is going to be leucine. Leucine is a hydrophobic, it is a branched chain amino acid, R is a basic amino acid, arginine, G is glycine, P is proline, completely a different set of the amino acid. Now again you see here nicely, you can see one positive sign given here. Because on the query sequence you had valine, on the subject sequence you are having leucine. Valine, leucine are coming under same type of amino acids. They are not same, they are not similar amino acids, but they come under the same type of amino acid, which is a branched chain amino acid. Is it not? So the properties will remain the same only. So that is why it is given as positive. If there is a huge difference between both the amino acids, then it will 100% show you the huge gap over here. So that gap indicates that in the subject sequence you are having serine, here it is glycine, here it is leucine, here it is proline. Like that you are able to find a lot of difference between the query sequence and the subject sequence. So that is why there is no any good similarity between both the sequences. Okay, now this again you have to take the screenshot of it and then come back to your page and put result number 2, and then you're going to put the heading as alignments, and then you're going to paste it. So this also you have copy pasted. Now get back to your BLAST site and click on the word dot plot. It will also take few minutes. Now you see again there is a gap, because there was a huge gap when you compare the query sequence with the subject sequence. Okay, so take this one also, the screenshot, and then you come back to your page and then you can put the third result, that is a dot plot, and then you can paste it. So your result has been completed now. So this is how you are supposed to do and get the result for the BLAST of two different protein sequences.